test, test. I'm missing one.
Welcome, 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 everyone. Who is excited to be in the house of the Lord today? Congratulations, you're all here. We're in ending the year strong. For those of you that are out there, please, please, please come on in. Take a seat. For those of you that are online, do me a quick favor and share this on your Facebook or social media page so that others can enjoy the service and worship with us. So who's ready to worship? The Word of God says that the Lord inhabits the praises of His people. Are you His people? Let's worship. God bless you.
All right, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. The last Sunday of 2021, we're going to give it all we got to praise Him in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, team. Let's get ready to praise the Lord. Come on, clap your hands to Jesus.
Yeah.
will bless the Lord at all times. Amen. I can't hear you. I will bless the Lord at all times. Amen. We're going to get ready to bless the Lord today. Amen. Woo! Come on, clap your hands to Jesus. We will bless the Well, this is our time where we slow down our worship. We take a minute to bow our hearts before the Lord. And Lord, we just come before you. We bow our hearts. We open this altar for anyone who wants to come forth and pray, to worship the Lord. Whatever that may be. However you want to worship the Lord. However you want to pray to him. This is the place. There's no shame here. There's no judgment here. We all are here to seek the Lord. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. So this past week, I've just been praying and thinking about next year. We all are preparing for a new season. Amen. And I thank the Lord for this year. No matter what we've been through, good or bad, we can thank him for all that we got through. We can bask and reflect on the goodness of God. Amen. And so I had just been praying in this song called Closer. It just talks about, I want to be closer than before. And I know we all have our relationship with the Lord, and we all were close to the Lord this year. But our prayer for the new year is, I want to be closer than before. I want to be closer than I've ever been. Take me deeper, Lord. And that's our heart today, that we just draw near and draw close to Jesus today. Amen. That we draw closer to him, that we desire and hunger for him. Yes, Jesus. Yes, Lord, we draw close to you, Lord, yes. Let's just stay in that atmosphere of worship. Begin to pray. Begin to praise his name. Draw close to him right now.
Presence. God, we are drawing near to you, and we believe that in this moment you are drawing near to us. Father, we hunger and we thirst for a life-changing, supernatural relationship and encounter with you. We ask, God, today that you would fill us anew. God, we want to live a life that is holy and pleasing before you. Give us, God, a grace and a mercy that is powerful, God, that we may remain in a deep and abiding relationship, God, with you. We thank you, God, for touching hearts today. We thank you, God, for speaking personally to each one of us today, God. We thank you, Lord, according to your word, that it is powerful and it is able to pierce even to the division, God, of soul and spirit, joint and marrow, and it is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of our hearts. So God, if there is any today that came with any other motive than to seek your face, may you break that chain now, God. May you tenderize their heart now, God. May you open their eyes to see you, oh God, and to pursue you, God. We thank you, Lord, that your spirit is resting upon this place. God, I see your spirit just coming to dwell in our midst, God. And as we sing, God, you are wrapping us in your arms. Thank you. Thank you for your holy embrace. We love you, Lord. We love you. And we thank you, Lord God, for all that you've done in our life. So much we are thankful for, God. And we are expecting, we are hoping, and we are believing, God, that we will end this year strong and ready for 2020. Have your way, God, that we may bring you all the glory in our life, in our life, in our life, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. And praise the Lord. Amen. God bless you, Chapel of Change. We are truly a blessed people. We are truly a blessed people. God bless you. We want to welcome you back once again to the house of the Lord. And if you're visiting for the first time, we say welcome. And it is our hope that you too receive a very personal and a very special touch from the Holy Spirit. Amen. If you haven't done so yet and you're new, we welcome you to visit our table in the back in the lobby. We have a special gift for you, which includes a free CD testimony of our lead pastor, Pastor Brian. We believe that his testimony will bless you. And if you've already heard his testimony but haven't gotten a copy, I still recommend you get one and you give it away. Amen. We believe that God moves through the testimony of other people. And so anyway, with that said, just God bless you. We hope that you had a time of reflection, a time of joy, and a time of peace wherever you were at this past Christmas week. And we are gearing up for 2022. And we're excited. Are you excited? Let me just say this. The reason we are so excited, no matter what situation you find yourself, no matter how dire and how crazy and how chaotic your situation may seem right now, there is hope. There is hope. God gives fresh hope day in and day out. You gotta believe that God is working and that God is moving and that God is doing something behind the scenes, whether you see it or not. And do you know why? Because we walk by faith, not by sight. When you hold on to that promise, you know God can move mountains at any time, at any moment. So we thank God. We thank God for you, for those joining us online. God bless you. Welcome to the house of the Lord at Chapel of Change. And with that said, we are excited. One of our pastors, Pastor Terry Beasley, is going to come and give a word in just a moment. So I'm going to encourage you to pull out your Bible, pull out a pen, and a notepad, because God says he fills those who hunger and thirst. Amen. So if you are hungry and thirsty for a word, you're going to be ready. With that said, we're going to show a very short video and we're going to get into the word. God bless you.
Welcome everybody to Chapel of Change. My name is Daryl and I work in the facilities and media.
And my name is Cassandra, and I serve on the media team as well. It is a joy and a privilege to have you here with us today. If you're a first-time guest, go ahead and grab your gift at our welcoming center. And please stay connected to Chapel of Change and Pastor Brian by texting your name to 562-393-7330. Once again, that's 562-393-7330. You can also download our phone app from our website, where you'll be able to find our latest teachings, preachings, and messages.
Join us on our midweek Bible study as Pastor Brian teaches about the armor of God. You can visit us on our Carson campus at 7:15 on Wednesdays. You can also join us on Paramount campus at 7:15 on Thursdays.
Go ahead and also check out our website for all upcoming events and services. Don't forget we have worship experiences all throughout the weekend, so there's no excuse for you not to make it to church. On Saturdays, we have worship at 5 p.m. in Whittier, and on Sundays, we have worship at 9:30 a.m. in Carson, 10 a.m. in Paramount and on live stream, 11:15 in Long Beach, 12:30 in Paramount, and 4:30 in Carson. Now get your Bible out and get ready for a word of fresh hope.
Good morning. Good morning, Chapel of Change. Good morning. Amen. Amen. How many know that we serve a good God? We serve a good God. Amen. Just want to just take this time out right now just to honor God just for his faithfulness and his love and his mercy that endures forever. You know, the Bible says that his mercies are new every day. Every day God's mercies is new. You know, and so as I got ready to prepare for this message, I thought about this being the last Sunday of the year. And by this being the last Sunday of the year, a lot of times we get ready to make our New Year's resolution. And we do good. We start off, you know, making all these promises and goals that we say we wanted to do and stuff. But we have a word going around here at Chapel of Change that God has laid it on Pastor Brian's heart, and that is all in. All in. All in. So I'm going to touch on today about us being all in for 2022. Are you all in today? Are you all in today? What does that mean to be all in? Does that mean that you want to come to church every Sunday, come to Bible study? So we're going to talk about what it means to be all in and what do you have to do to get all in. And so I believe that in order to be all in here at Chapel of Change, because there's an anointing here on this house, and God is speaking to all of us, and he wants us to be all in, not just at our church, but in our homes, with our families, and our children, and our neighborhood, with our neighbors. He wants us to be all in. Amen? So this morning, I want to talk to you out of the book of Hebrews, the 12th chapter. Now remember, our thought today is all in. Now you made the commitment. I've heard you say today, and I even said to myself that I'm all in. But in order to be all in, you have to prepare. You got to take care of some things. Amen? So let's look at Hebrews, the 12th chapter, verses 1 and 2. Hebrews, the 12th chapter, verses 1 and 2. If you have it, say amen. You that are watching online also, I believe this word is for you also. You couldn't be here in the service, but you're watching today, and God has this word specifically for you today also. Hebrews, the 12th chapter. I'm reading out of the New King James Version. Therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, I believe I read it again. Therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, the author, he said, let us lay aside every weight and sin. Let us lay aside every weight and sin. That's what the Spirit of God is saying to us this morning, this afternoon. Let us, all of us. It wasn't just talking to the members, but it was talking to the preachers and the choir members and everybody in the church. He was talking to all. He said, let us, because we all have some issues, amen? Huh? So I hope you have your pencil and your paper and you begin to write some things down as the Holy Spirit begins to quicken your heart. He said, let us lay aside every weight and sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with the endurance the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and sat down at the right hand on the throne of God. The author here was speaking to all of us, and he was telling us to lay aside every weight and sin. But he says, therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses. Who was this great cloud of witnesses the writer was talking about? These were the heroes of faith. If you go back to the 11th chapter of Hebrews, where the Bible talks about all of these great men and women of God who were the heroes of our faith, who trusted God no matter what, who didn't give up. So you see, it's going to take some faith in order for us to lay aside every weight and sin. For you see, these heroes of faith, they sacrificed so much. The Bible says that some of them were able to watch their children being brought back to life. The Bible also said that some of them were persecuted. Some of them were put in animals' clothing. Some of them were sawn asunder. But they yet held on to God. They yet trusted God. The Bible says, by faith, Enoch, he pleased God. By faith, the heroes of faith, they laid the foundation. Then the Bible also says, then looking to Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Look to Jesus, who's the author and the finisher of our faith. So my first point this morning is, lay aside every weight and sin. For the race is not given to the swift nor the strong, but to him that endures until the end. So the first point again is, lay aside every weight and sin. For that word lay aside, it means to put away. It means to cast off. It means to lay apart. It means to put away. It gives a picture of some of us laying something down at the same time, just pushing it away. Again, I'm talking about laying aside every weight and sin. The word implies that it gives a deliberate decision to make a permanent change. Do you hear me today? When he said lay aside, he was talking to, it's something that we have to do. If we want to be all in for 2022, there's some things that we have to lay aside. Huh? Lay aside. There are things in this life that are hard to give up. Amen? There are things in this life that are sometimes hard for us to give up. But some of us find it easier than others. Amen? But there's some things, if you just stop just for a moment and just begin to reflect on your life. Where are you today? Has God been speaking to you about laying aside some weights and some sins? He was talking to the believers, us. We have a tendency to come to church and carry a lot of excess baggage. Amen? Just think about this for a second. Picture you sitting down with your big bowl of your favorite candy or your potato chips or your ice cream or your beef jerky or your hot Cheetos or your oatmeal cookies. But just picture something that you like to eat all the time. Some of your favorite snacks. You just can't seem to let go. And that big bowl of what you like to eat on, what you like to snack on, is sitting there. And you know you had one too many. But then every now and then you go back and you grab one more. Huh? But that bowl is not to test you, but you just want to indulge over and over again. But we got to stop indulging. We got to push that bowl away. We got to push that bowl far, far away. And sometimes my wife, when I have my, she know I like candy. And she tell me to stop eating so much sweets because it takes its toll. Hello, somebody. But so she'll take my candy and so she'll hide it so I can't reach it anymore. So she's taking it away from me. At the same time, it's what we got to do with some of the sins and the weights that we've been holding on to. We got to be able to take those things off and be able to push them far, far away. You know those things that get you all wrapped up and all tied up? You know what your issues are, huh? Well, let me just talk about a few of them. Maybe I may hit home just a little bit. Why we have to lay aside every weight and sin? Because sin can hold us back. Sin can hinder our prayer life. Sin, every weight, every hindrance, it keeps us from running effectively the race that God has for us. So this morning, as I begin to share, get rid of any kind of sin, any kind of weight that is holding you back. Carrying anything extra slows us down. You ever wonder why you can't get a prayer through? You wonder why you can't seem to keep your joy? Because we've been walking around and we're carrying extra weight. I know this is not a message to make you jump up and down, but it's going to be a message to set you free. It's going to be a message to give you deliverance. It's going to be a message to help you give God your all in all for 2022. Amen? For Jesus has called us to run a race. It's a faith race. It's a long distance race. It's a race full of hills and valleys. Amen? It's a race full of hills and valleys and full of obstacles, things that are going to cause you to slow down sometime. But it's a race that you and I will have to be able to endure. So we're talking about this morning about laying aside every weight and every sin. Galatians, the 5th chapter and the 7th verse says, it says, for you were running well, but who hindered you from obeying the truth? You were running well. I was running well, but what hindered me from obeying the truth? A lot of people, as they start off excited and they start off sharing their testimony, and as time goes on, they begin to fizzle out. They begin to, you would see them all the time on Sunday, you would see them all the time on Thursday and Wednesdays, but as time began to go on, as the weights of life begin to drag them down, the weights of sin begin to drag them down, they begin to fizzle out. That's why the writer says, you did run well, but who hindered you from obeying the truth? What weight is slowing you down? What's causing you not to get your prayers through today? What's causing you to get a quick attitude? Huh? What's causing you to want to gossip so much and to talk about somebody so much? What weights are you carrying that making you think it's okay to have sex outside the marriage, but didn't come to church every Sunday? What weights are you carrying that makes you think it's okay to live together, man and woman, and to have sex outside of marriage? What makes you think it's okay to carry those kind of weights around? Weights. What are some of those weights that I'm talking about this morning? I touched on a few already. Is it backbiting? Is it murmuring? Is it gossip? Is it lying? Is it cheating? Is it stealing? Is it knowing to do the right thing, but not doing it? Did you hear what I said? Is it knowing to do the right thing, but not doing it? Is that a sin? Yes, it is. The Bible says in James, the 4th chapter, the 17th verse, says, so whoever knows the right thing to do and fails to do it, for he himself is sin. He's sin. We've sinned. You know, and I didn't realize that, but if you know, if God has been speaking to you about some weights that you've been carrying, if God has been dealing with you, you don't need the preacher to tell you that's wrong. But if God has been dealing with you, if God has been speaking to you and said, hey, you need to cut that out, you need to let that go, and you don't let it go, it's a sin. First Peter, second chapter, the first verse. Therefore, putting aside all malice, all deceit, and hypocrisy, and envy, and all slander. James 1:21. Therefore, putting aside all filthiness, all that remains of the wickedness, in humility receive the word implanted, which is able to save your souls. Ephesians 4:4. Therefore, laying aside falsehood, speak truth one of another with your neighbor, for we are members of one another. As Christians, we must learn to put away, to cast off all the burdens, every hindrance, every offense that can easily beset us. We have to train for this race, amen? We have to train for this race. Hebrews 5:14 says, but solid food is for the mature, who because of practice have their senses trained to discern good and evil. Let me read it again. Hebrews 5:14. We have to train for this race. We have to train for this race. It says, but solid food is for the mature, who because of their practice have their senses trained to discern good and evil. Some of us have been trying to run this race, and you've been wondering why you get winded so quickly. Some of us, we've been running this race, but then we get winded. We start off with a big bang, and then we get winded. It's because you're carrying extra weight. It's because we're carrying extra weight. We're still carrying those sins that the Bible said that we need to let them go. Huh? Because the Bible says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a what? He is a what? He's a new creation. And old things are what? Are passed away. But we have a tendency because of those things that we still like. Those things that we still want to hold on to. But the Bible says that God, he is what? He is a jealous God. And he wants us to, be what? He wants us to be holy, for he is holy. The Bible also says too much is given. Much is required from us. I'm sorry, but I got to drop this on all of us today. We come here to Chapel of Change. We go to a word church where the word is going forth every Sunday. And guess what? Too much is given, much is required. Too much is given, much is required. So there's no reason why we should continue to walk around and barely get by with weights and stuff still hanging on us. Amen? For the Bible says, it says, so whom the Son set free is what? Is free indeed. But see, these weights, okay, see, well, let me just back up for a second. Now, these weights, you say, because the Bible says, it says weights and sin, right? Isn't that what he said? He said for us to lay aside every weight. Maybe it's those little things that you think is not so much of sin. But it's still hindering you from being all that God has called you to be. And you and I know what those things are. Maybe it's watching too much TV. Or maybe watching the wrong thing on TV. So it's not a sin to watch TV, right? But maybe it's a weight. Huh? Maybe it's a weight. What are you listening to? Music is not a sin, right? But what kind of music are you listening to? Maybe it's a weight that's causing you not to be able to pray the way you should pray. We're talking about weights to lay those things aside. I want to be all that God wants me to be. What about you today? Huh? What about you? For God is speaking to me. God has let me know, Terry, there's some things that you got to let go. I didn't say there was a sin, but some things that is not, you're not giving me your all in your all. And I want to give God my all in my all, especially for 2022. What about you today? So as the word of God goes forth today, think about those things that you say are not sin, but their weights. For the Bible says those things can easily ensnare you, can easily trip you up, can easily tie you down. It can easily immobilize you. See, we in a race. We in a race, family. We in a race. We got to run this race with endurance and patience, right? But how can you run when you got weights all on you? Huh? The believers trying to run. They trying to run. Barely getting by. We got to lay aside every weight and sin which can trip us up, which can cause us to miss the mark that God has for me and you today. Huh? I don't know about you, but I want to be free. I want to be free. What about you? And some of these things you can't just shake off. But the Bible says you got to put them off and throw them way away. Amen? You know what you like. You know that weight. Get rid of it. Let it go. In the name of Jesus. Let it go. In the name of Jesus. Okay, I feel my help coming on right now. There's some weight that need to be taken off today. Holy Spirit, speak to them right now. Speak to us, oh God. Reveal to us those weights and those sins that we've been carrying, God. Let me just tell you about how sneaky and tricky these weights and sins could be, because you think that you've been in church a long time and this stuff don't really affect you. But sin is sin, and sin is subtle. Sin will have you thinking doing right and have you all messed up. Huh? That's why you got to stay before God. God, you know my heart. Help me, God, to do what's right. Help me to please you. You know, I was reading and I read about, how many know the actress, she passed a long time ago, Elizabeth Taylor? You know, she was known for her great acting, but she's also known for her looks, right? She's a very pretty lady, right? And she's very attractive. And I was reading about Elizabeth Taylor, and you know, as you get older, things change, right? And so I was reading about Elizabeth Taylor, how she had gained a lot of weight. And she had gained all this weight. And so she stopped going out for certain roles because she had picked up so much weight. But she really didn't know she had gained all that weight. And so one time she went to a hotel and she had got out of the shower. And there was this great big mirror from head to toe. And when she got out the mirror, she saw how much weight she had really gained. But now she had gained this weight for some time, but she really didn't realize, because the other time she had a mirror, she just had like a little mirror that only showed her face. And so it was hiding the rest of her. And so Liz went on a program. I don't know if it was Jenny Craig or a Jacqueline program, but what some kind of program she went on, and she lost some weight. I know I need to lose a little weight myself. What about you? Anybody need to lose any weight? Okay, no, okay. But anyway, oh, brother, amen. We're going to do that too, amen. Well, anyway, Liz, she went on this diet, and she began to lose her weight, and she came back out, and she began to look the way she used to look in the past, and she would go out, and she would apply for these new roles, and she would get these roles because she felt confident, she was looking good about herself. And you know what, we today, maybe sin or these weights have been tricking us. Maybe we just only just being seeing a little snapshot of how we think we are. We have a snapshot of our life and we think our lives are okay. But maybe just this, you that are listening also, maybe take the time right now and just examine your lives. Let's examine our lives right now and let's see what kind of weights are really we still holding on to? Because we all have some kind of weights that we're still holding on to. And you know what happens is this? As you begin to worship the Lord, right? As you come into God's presence, what does God do? When you come into his presence, it feels good, right? But if you come into his presence, you come into the presence of God, God begins to do what? And when you're praying and talking to God, you know what he does? He begins to reveal you to him. He begins to reveal how wicked you are. He begins to reveal how wicked I am and how much more I need to grow in order to please him. Huh? So I'm not preaching a message of condemnation, but I'm preaching a message of fresh hope. God wants us to be free. He wants to walk in the liberty that Christ has given us. Amen? How much time? Okay. Got 3 minutes left. I can't really see the time here. Okay. So in order, Pastor Brian told me, I'm going to tell you something. This is what Pastor Brian told me. He says, Terry, don't get caught up by the hype of the people clapping. He said, don't let them pull you in like that. And he said, don't let them pull you in like that. So, okay, but thank you anyway, amen. Thank you anyway. So let's examine our lives, family, and let's cast off the weights that hinder us, amen. And this is one way you can do this. It says keeping the weights off with a garment of praise. We can keep these weights off with a garment of praise. For Isaiah 61:3 says, it says this. It says the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. So put on your garment of praise to keep unnecessary weight off. Did you hear what I just said? Let me read it again. It says the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. So put on your garment of praise to keep unnecessary weight off. Amen. So we got to praise God. Amen. You want to keep that weight off? Begin to praise God. Begin to magnify his name. When you begin to praise God, we lift him up. The weights begin to fall. The chains begin to fall off. Amen. So let's keep those weights off. And I know, and I'm going to move on. I'm going to leave this weight alone because I know it's some of y'all get it's kind of touchy, you know, because some of us have weight problems and we've been trying to lose weight for a long time. Amen. You know, and we can do good, and that weight come right back on us so fast. Same way with sin. So you got to watch out. The same way with sin. We can't let our guards down. I think I give me a cheat day, right? And I cheat all day. Then I cheat tomorrow. Huh? You can't be doing that and trying to lose weight. And the same way with sin. Huh? You don't get no cheat day with sin, do you? Huh? Huh? We sometimes live like that, don't we? Huh? We sometimes live like that, don't we? I got a cheat day today. No, you don't. The devil is a liar, man. Okay, let me get ready to wrap this up here. So as we prepare ourselves to be all in for 2022, my second point is this. Keep your eyes on Jesus, for he is the author and the finisher of our faith. How important is Jesus to you? Huh? How important is Jesus to you? Because we got to keep our eyes on him. Because when you look at man, if you look at me, I'm liable to disappoint you. Huh? So it's not good for you to put your trust in so much trust in man. But the Bible says to look unto Jesus, who's the author and the finisher of our faith. He's the perfect example. Amen? So how important is Jesus to you? Well, first of all, we need to look to Jesus in everything. We need to look to Jesus in everything. The Bible says in Acts the 17th chapter, in the 28th verse, it says, for in him we live and we move and we exist. We have our very being. For many Christians today, they look to Jesus when trouble strikes. But when everything is going well, we don't really look to Jesus. But you got to look to Jesus in everything. Look to Jesus in the good times and in the bad times. Look to Jesus. Look to Jesus. Look to Jesus. Look to Jesus, family. Look to Jesus in our victories as well in our trials. Amen. And also, we need to look to Jesus for everything. And you know what I said the first time? I said, look to Jesus in everything. Now we need to look to Jesus for everything. The Bible says in John, the 14th chapter, and the 13th verse, it says, whoever you ask in my name, I will do it, so the Father may be glorified in the Son. So we as believers, we need to depend on the Lord for all of our supplies. Amen? We need to stop relying on our jobs and our finances and our bank accounts, but we need to look to Jesus for everything. Amen? Huh? Can I get a witness, somebody, huh? Because you know what? Those jobs will fail you. Those jobs, they sometimes lay off, they close down, they shut down. But if you look to Jesus, he says, I change not, huh? I'm the same today, yesterday, and for what? Forevermore. So we got to keep on looking to Jesus. Look to Jesus for everything. Look to Jesus for hope. Look to Jesus for joy. Look to Jesus for peace, huh? Some people look for peace in a bottle, or they look for peace in a plant, and they roll up and they can smoke. When I say look to Jesus for joy, look to Jesus for direction. Look to Jesus, the one that has everything. Amen? Philippians, the 4th chapter, the 19th verse, and I'm getting ready to wrap it up. For he will supply all of our needs according to his riches and glory through Christ Jesus. So we look unto Jesus. We look to Jesus in everything. We look to Jesus for everything. Family, please, please, as I get ready to take my seat, look to Jesus. He'll never disappoint you. Look to Jesus. I'm reminded of the story when the storm was going real bad and when it was about Peter. Remember when Peter was on the boat and the storm began to come and it began to shake the winds and everything? And he looked out there and he saw Jesus. And Jesus told him, come on, come over here. And he began to walk on water. He began to walk on water because he was looking to Jesus. When you look to Jesus, miracles begin to happen, huh? When you look to Jesus, maybe somebody in your family is sick. You need a miracle. Look to Jesus, who's the author and the finisher of our faith, huh? Look to Jesus. Miracles begin to happen when you look to Jesus. Maybe you need a miracle today. Who need a miracle today? Look to Jesus today. The Bible said there's nothing too hard for him. Nothing too difficult for him if you just look to Jesus. But what happened when you take your eyes off of Jesus? Y'all remember what happened to Peter? He stopped looking at Jesus. Guess what happened? He began to sink. And many times of us today, when we take our eyes off of Jesus and we begin to look at the problem and the situation, we begin to sink. Keep your eyes on Jesus. Keep your eyes on him. Keep your eyes on Jesus. Bibles, and I know sometimes it's hard. It gets very difficult for us sometimes. Sometimes things happen in life that are so devastating. It sometimes causes us sometimes to look the other way and take our eyes off of Jesus. We begin to look at our problem. But Jesus has it all. He's able to fix it for us if we would just continue to trust him. Amen? So family, continue to trust him no matter what. Because you know what the Bible says, it says for the believers, for the Christians, for we walk by faith and not by sight, right? So it's not by what I see, but it's by what I believe, what I know God's going to do, right, man? Because I'm looking to the author and the finisher of what? Of my faith. Amen? Let's pray. Maybe today God spoke to you as the word of God was going forth. And you made a commitment and you said, Lord, I want to be all in for you, all in for 2022. But God has revealed some things to us today, some weights and some sins that we need to let go and to take off. Maybe that's you. God has been dealing with you for such a time, but today is your day where he's going to help you to take off those weights and those sins. I can't see. I don't know what those weights that you've been carrying. You don't know what the weights I've been carrying, but we can release them to Jesus today. The Bible says, come unto me, all ye that labor and heavy burden, and I will give you rest. You've been walking around. We've been walking around too long with these weights. God wants to set us free. So let's close our eyes just for a moment of reflection and just think and just begin to open your hearts right now. Begin to talk to the Lord your own way and ask God to help you take those weights off. But there's one here today. You haven't accepted the Lord, but you came to church today, or you've been coming for a while, and you've been carrying a lot of weight, and you want to release those weights today. God is here. We are here to pray with you, to help you lift the burdens you're carrying. If that's you, stand to your feet, and we're just going to pray with you. Stand to your feet, that's it. And we're going to pray for you. And maybe you're here today. You've been coming to church Sunday after Sunday. You're in the worship team. You're in the host team. You're even on the pastoral staff. But maybe God is speaking to us today. For he said, let us lay aside every weight. If the Spirit of God is quickening you today and he's revealed to you what those weights are, stand to your feet as God begins to release those weights in your life. Stand with me, for you see, I'm standing also in prayer. I want to give God my all in 2022. I don't want to walk around carrying any weights of sin that's going to cause me to miss out on what God has in store for me. I want to be able to come before his throne boldly and pray and seek his face and knowing that God will hear my prayer. I'm not saying that I'm holy, holy, but I want to be right before God. What about you today? Do you want to be right before God today? If there's some weights that need to fall off, let's stand up, let those weights begin to fall off. And I'm going to pray in the name of Jesus because I believe God. And for you that are watching right now online, if there's some weights in your life that you need to be removed, the Bible said that for you have to lay them aside. I have to lay them aside. But when you take the effort, God comes in and he gives us the strength to be able to do it. So we're getting ready to pray. Family, let's pray. Let's pray. People are standing. People's hearts open up right now to God. Let's begin to pray. You know what those weights are in your life. Begin to pray, family. And here's you that are standing. Here's a prayer I want you to repeat after me. Lord, say, Lord, I know you that on my side and that you want to help me. So today, I'm asking you to help me to lay aside attitudes, negative thought patterns, bad habits that keep pulling me down into miserable defeat. Lord, I'm exhausted trying to live for you while dragging along these old weights behind me at the same time. I need to drop them and leave them behind. So today, I'm asking you to help me make the big break. Help me make this day I permanently drop all the unnecessary weight that hinders me and walk away from them forever. Amen. Let me pray. Father God, we thank you for today. Thank you for your word, Lord. Thank you for all these, God, that are under the sound of my voice. Thank you for those, God, that have stood up, God. God, I pray that you would continue to give us strength, God, to do what's right, God, to please you, God. Continue to help us, God, to get rid of every weight that continue to trip us up, God. And God, from this day forward, we're going to serve you, God, with all of our heart, our souls, our mind. And everyone said, amen and amen.
Amen. Come on, give the Lord some praise. That's an awesome word. Thank you, Pastor Terry. And you know, everything that he was saying is true. It's true. And as we transition to our giving, I want to read you a scripture. And it's found in the book of Exodus, chapter 25, if we can adjust this mic. The book of Exodus, chapter 25, verse 1 and 2. And this is what it says. Then the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, speak to the children of Chapel of Change, that they bring me an offering. For everyone who gives it willingly with his heart, you shall take my offering, says the Lord. What is he talking about? He's talking about building the tabernacle, talking about building God's house, God's church, equipping the facility to facilitate the people of God to meet your needs. As we give through our Christ birthday offering, it's not too late to give. It's never too late to give to the kingdom of God. The finances that you sow in, I'm talking sow in, not just give, sow in to the kingdom of God, will reap a harvest back in your life. As we sow through Christ's birthday offering for our media room, what are we doing? We're equipping the house of God to facilitate the people of God through CDs, through videos, through Fresh Hope Radio, to give back to the people of God hope. Most of you came to Jesus Christ because somebody told you about God. Somebody spoke into your life. And God is telling the people of God here, bring me the silver, the gold, and the bronze. Read it for yourselves. Because God was building the tabernacle so that his people can gather together and worship our God. As you prepare your offering and as you prepare to give Christ's birthday offering, it's not too late. You might say, well, you know, Christmas is already passed. It's too late. No, it's not too late. You can still give into it. Ask God. Ask God to speak to you about that. We can give through debit machine, or we can give through envelope. We can facilitate that in the lobby for you. There is a tithing box that you can deposit your envelopes as well. You can give through chapelofchange.org. Most of our family gives online already. Or you can give if you text to give 1-888-364-4483. Text CHAPEL. Or you can do it the old-fashioned way and mail it in. Many people still do that. To 6701 Alondra Boulevard in the city of Paramount, California. You know what? I can't stress enough. And for those of you that give, and even if you say, Pastor, you know what? I'm not able to give right now. That's okay. God bless you. God will provide and meet those needs in your life according to his riches and glory. There will be a time that you're able to give to the kingdom of God. I remember when I first got saved, I would pray at the altar and I didn't have a job. And I said, Lord, I want to tithe into your kingdom. I want to give to your kingdom. I hear it all the time, but I don't have a job. And you know what? About a week later, God provided me with a job. And I was able to start tithing into the kingdom of God. Not because I wanted a return, but because I wanted to invest in people's lives. And that is what we do when we sow our finances into the kingdom of God. I have a few announcements. We have baptisms coming up January 9th. Please see Pastor Benny. Pastor Benny, can you raise your hand? Amen. So if you haven't been baptized and you would like to, there is a sign-up sheet in the back. You can sign up. Amen. I may sign up and get baptized all over again. You never know. Amen. You never know. We have our midweek worship service. We're not going to have it this week. So you got all this week off. You have all this week off. Some of you are not even going to know what to do with yourselves. Amen. You might show up and the parking lot's empty. Amen. But listen. You are the church. Wherever you're at, you are the church. I recommend this, that you get into your word. Study what Pastor Brian taught this past week on the armor of God. Refresh your memory. Study it. Stay in the word. Don't wait till next Sunday. Get in your word. Amen. There will be no midweek worship services. So please. Consider Christ's birthday offering. I cannot stress it enough. Amen. So as I conclude, I'm going to ask Pastor Kenny to come up. And Father, I pray for your people that have given today, and even those that aren't able to give, that you would bless them. As the ushers come up to the front, they're going to receive the offering from you. Father, we thank you for your goodness and for your mercy. In the mighty name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, as the ushers are released to receive the offering. Amen.
Stand together. And as we prepare for the blessing, there were some of you that did not stand, and that there are some weights and sins that I can't take into 2022. And I want it off of me now. Pastor is going to come and pray for you for something you're carrying that needs to go away from your life. So after the blessing, if that's you, whatever it was or the reason was you didn't stand up, but you know there's a weight on you, and the pastor is going to come and they're going to agree with you that you're not going to take it into 2022. As a matter of fact, they'll believe with you for right now for that weight to come off of you. That's you. Take this opportunity for these pastors to agree with you. And I also would encourage you that this week that you'll get along with God. Spend some time with the Lord before we go into the new year. He wants to talk to you. And so, Father, it's our custom to just lift our hands before the Lord. and receive this blessing. I'm going to speak this over you too, that just preached at the Carson campus, that God will bless you, that special blessing for the next 10 years. Chapel of Change 10th anniversary is in October. And so, Father, I pray would you have birthed in my spirit this blessing. In Deuteronomy 11, it says, may the Lord God of your fathers make you 1,000 times more numerous than you are, and bless you as he has promised you. The glory belongs to God and God alone. This blessing of spiritual authority for the divine kingdom of God, of power. Father, in the name of Jesus, I declare and decree as we cross over from 2022 to 2032, a blessing, God. A blessing for obedience. Every weight must go in the name of Jesus. We declare and decree it in the name of Jesus. The man of God has spoken it to us. And so, Father, we receive it even now, God. In the name of Jesus, every weight must go. In the name of Jesus. And the Holy Spirit that empowers us, Father. Father, as we cross over, we pray for your blessing, God, to be a blessing. And even now we pray over our family in the name of Jesus. We call them by name. Those who are not saved, God, in the name of Jesus, pour out your blessing. Pour out your blessing on our families. Pour out your blessing. Pour out your blessing on Chapel of Change. Pour out your blessing. Pour out your blessing, God. This is our prayer. Pour out your blessing on your people. In Jesus' name, if you receive it, if you receive it, put your hands together. We will not carry it. We will not carry it another moment, not another minute. We won't carry it out of this place in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, let the pastors pray over you. In Jesus' name.